The FR22 International Conference on Fast Reactors and Associated Fuel Cycles was held at the headquarters of the International Atomic Energy Agency in Vienna from 19 to 22 April 2022. Balasubramaniam Venkatraman, representing the Indira Gandhi Center for Atomic Research, presented a report on the current state of the Indian FAST program. The speaker recalled that the Indian nuclear industry works with all three major fissile isotopes. Indian nuclear power plants operate on uranium-235, the FBTR research reactor operates on plutonium-239 and the PFBR power reactor under construction will operate, and uranium-233 is used in the small Kamini reactor with a capacity of 30 thermal kilowatts. He added that all three fuels are used in one center in Kalpakkam. Then the speaker moved on to the story about the history and main achievements of the FBTR FAST research reactor, until the launch of the PFBR, which is the flagship of India's FAST program. The fundamental decision to start work on the rapid program was made in India in 1968. A year later, the nuclear departments of India and France entered into an agreement on cooperation in the construction of a FAST research reactor. In 1971, a nuclear center was established at Kalpakkam, and in 1972, construction of the FBTR started. Around 1978, it was decided to refocus the FBTR on carbide fuel. On October 18, 1985, the reactor reached criticality for the first time, and on March 7, 2022, it was brought to its design capacity of 40 thermal megawatts, or 10 electrical megawatts, for the first time. Throughout its history, FBTR has become a forge of resources for the nuclear industry. More than 100 engineers and more than 50 technicians, as well as almost 30 scientists, have been trained at the reactor. Various types of fuels were tested at the reactor: carbide, metal, oxide, and even TRISO. In addition, irradiation experiments were carried out with various structural materials. The speaker recalled that the FBTR reactor had successfully demonstrated the closure of the fuel cycle, thanks to a pilot plant for the reprocessing of irradiated fuel, commissioned in 2003. To date, the FBTR reactor has worked for 36 years, and the question arose of its extension. It is quite realistic, given that the reactor reached its design capacity just recently. To reduce the dose load on the bottom plate of the reactor, which is the most vulnerable component, it was decided to modify the design of the fuel assemblies and add tungsten carbide pellets to it as a bottom shield. Largely due to this measure, it should be possible to leave the FBTR in service until 2034-2035. Of course, the part devoted to India's plans to develop a rapid program and close the nuclear fuel cycle is of greatest interest in the report. The speaker announced that in 2022, India has successfully completed the first phase of the FAST program, which included the operation of the FBTR reactor and the closing of its fuel cycle. The second stage, called a feasibility study by the speaker, should be completed in 2030. The stage includes the startup and operation of the PFBR 500 reactor, as well as the construction of a plant for processing its spent nuclear fuel. The third stage is the commercialization of technologies. It is due to be completed in 2047 and will include the construction of two units at the Kalpakkam site with commercial fast sodium reactors of 500 megawatts each, powered by MOX fuel. At the same time, the development of metal fuel and pyroprocessing technologies for fast sodium reactors will continue. It is assumed that a new research reactor, codenamed FBTR-2, will operate on metallic fuel. Its launch is scheduled for the horizon of 2040. And after 2050, India will switch to the serial construction of power fast reactors with metallic fuel. In this regard, the speaker said that in India, experimental rods were made from metallic fuel from uranium or a mixture of uranium and plutonium in a zirconium matrix. The test rods are currently being irradiated at the FBTR. Subscribe to the channel, there is still a lot of interesting nuclear news ahead.